All right, I can wait no longer. I'm in such suspense to see what we're going to choose for you in this first U substitution example on page one of the U substitution packet. Okay, let's put ourselves out of our misery here. What's it going to be? Think of which of these looks, okay, so it says terms whose derivatives also appear. Well, x cubed plus x squared. That might be a good choice because if I take a derivative, I happen to get this. So that checks off the first of the three kind of suggestions. I think it actually checks off all three of these. You could consider this a more innermost part of the function because although both parts are in parentheses, e is raised to this power. It's kind of stuck inside an exponent, whereas this one's really just sitting out front being multiplied. Lastly, it could be considered a little bit more complicated than this other part here because it's to a slightly higher power. This one's a third degree versus that being a second degree. So we had this 50-50 chance of what we wanted to call this mystery letter U, and the right choice is x cubed plus x squared. The good news is that when you get to this step, if you're ever iffy on which of the two you should pick, and lots of times it's a 50-50 choice like this, you'll know right away if we didn't make the right choice. And then we go back and choose the other part. So this handles step one. It says introduce U to stand for some expression in terms of x, chosen to try to simplify the integral. Step two says, can you rewrite the integral in terms of U? We're going to do that first. So we're going to go up to the integral, the original function. It's the integral of, well, we don't have anything to plug in for this yet, so we're going to just leave it. 3x squared plus 2x. We're going to leave the e, but instead of saying e to all this stuff, we called that u. So we're going to say e to the u instead of that complicated expression. So we've already gotten a little bit simpler. And then afterwards, we have dx. So we have ourselves this mixture of variables here, some x's in the problem and now a u. Our goal now is we need to get this entire thing, all the x's gone. There has to be some way to write this in terms of u. And this is what we'll be practicing with the next couple of days. Off to the side, look at what this says. It says compute du dx. What does that make you think of? This process actually involves derivatives. That's a derivative of u in terms of x. And it says solve that for dx. This is going to be a tricky part too. So off to the side, can you take what we substituted for u and take a derivative? We'll call that derivative the change in u with respect to x. Du dx is a derivative. And what is the derivative of x cubed plus x squared? Don't confuse yourself. We're so into antiderivatives right now. Sometimes it's easy to forget how to go backwards and just take a plain derivative. So do this slowly. Derivative power rule, the 3 comes down, it's x to one power lower, x squared, and the 2 comes down by power rule, and you're one power lower. We could call that 2x. So we take a derivative. Notice, ooh, this is pretty familiar. I think we can get stuff to cancel. And this is something we've never done before. This next part of the step says solve for dx. That's a little crazy. We've never, this is called separation of variables. We've never split up the du and the dx before, but you consider these, you can consider them two mathematical quantities, one over the other. And how would I get the dx up out of the denominator? I would multiply it over to the other side. So what's crazy is we're going to multiply both sides by dx to get du equals 3x squared plus 2x. And we'll say dx. We're multiplying dx over to the other side. I'll show that step too. It gets multiplied over here and cancels, and it gets multiplied over here and stays. And you just have du equals that. So that's a little wacky. We're splitting those two little differentials there. The last part of step two says, can you solve for dx? So in this side work, we have to do one last thing to get dx by itself, and it should make the problem a little bit better. So we're going to solve for dx, make it du over 3x squared plus 2x equals dx. And I want to circle this because it is going to be a piece to our puzzle. So u, we already plugged in to the original function. We have e to the u instead of e to that third power expression. Now the du, we're going to plug in for dx. We're trying to get all the x's out of this expression so we can make it look simpler and easier to integrate. So we're going to write this as integral of 3x squared plus 2x e to the u. And instead of writing dx, hear me out here, we'll write this entire fraction. So it'll be times du over 3x squared plus 2x. If you are still with me, I hope that you notice something. Some good stuff is about to happen. We chose the right u because we chose the u whose derivative also appeared, and it looks like we have the same thing on top and bottom of this fraction. So how simple can you get? This whole term is going to cancel with this whole binomial down here, and there's not much left over. One of the easiest things to integrate is left over. You have integral of e to the u taken with respect to u. We've done two great things. We've made this a lot simpler and easier to integrate, and we've gotten it all in terms of one variable. We've gotten rid of the x in the problem. It's a little weird process, but we're through the worst part of it. Now I say take an integral. Step three says evaluate the integral. So when you evaluate the integral, and then in your answer, we'll do some subbing back in again. So let's take an integral. E to the u, well, e to the x is its own integral, so we'll leave it as e to the u. And then it will get a plus c on the end of it, so I'll put a plus c here. And we're almost ready to leave this as our final answer. The only problem with leaving this is that it is in terms of u, and we want our final answer to be in terms of x. So the last part of step three was replace u with its original expression in terms of x. So we're gonna go back to this answer, and instead of writing u, we're gonna write what we know u equals from what we had originally substituted. So it'll be e to what we said u equals x cubed plus x squared plus c. And that is your solution. And I have to hand it to you, this has to be one of the most complicated antiderivatives we've ever taken, and you guys did a great job with it. We could always check this answer. If you take a derivative, you should get the original back. So a derivative of this should get you that. And that's the idea of u substitution. I want to look at one more example with you, and it's going to be the first one on the next page. I promise you that in a couple days, these will get easier. The more of them that you try, the more you get kind of used to the process, and it gets a little bit easier to make a u choice. So stay with me on this one. Let's try it. My first step is I got to look at this and decide, well, I can't just do this in a simple way. Like, I can't really get rid of the fraction and solve this in an easy way. So I want to try to use u substitution. We have this 50-50 choice of what to make u. I think u either needs to be the whole numerator, the 4x to the third, or the whole denominator, the x to the fourth plus 7. And I got to think in my head about those suggestions. What do we say were good u choices? Well, we said something whose derivative appears. Do you see something whose derivative appears? I think so. I think this denominator's derivative is actually the numerator. So I'm thinking maybe u should be this. Maybe we should choose the entire denominator as our u choice instead of the numerator. Its derivative appears. What was the second suggestion? Second suggestion was the innermost part of the function. That doesn't really apply to this problem. There isn't really an innermost part of this fraction. But the third suggestion's good, the more troublesome or more complicated part. Since the bottom is to a higher power, it's a very good u choice. Pick the higher power over the lower power. Now we're going to rewrite the original as much as we can in terms of u. So instead of writing the denominator as x to the fourth plus 7, we're going to write the denominator as u. For now, the numerator needs to stay, so we'll leave the 4x to the third and we'll leave the dx, but we're going to handle that in a second once we've done some side work, some differentiating, some derivative side work to be able to plug in for x. Okay, next step, we're going to take a derivative. So we'll take a derivative of this, we'll call it du dx. And the derivative, I'm going to use power rule, is going to be what? 4x to the third, and then derivative of 7 is just nothing, right? It is the numerator. So we got lucky again here. Next, we're supposed to solve this for just dx, which is kind of weird. We can do that by multiplying both sides by dx. It's almost a cross multiply here, and get du equals 4x to the third dx. And last part of this side work, solve what you just wrote for dx. Get it by itself. So du equals 4x to the third, whoops, du over 4x to the third equals dx. I'm going to circle this so I can use it to sub in. So we already subbed in u. We subbed it in for that denominator. Now we're going to sub in this for dx. Instead of writing dx, we'll write this. That should hopefully make some things cancel. So it'll be integral of 4x to the third over u, but not for long because dx is du over that 4x to the third. That substitution is perfect because it's going to make your x's completely vanish. The dx is gone as well, and all we have to integrate is something that we're used to. Integral of, well, there's ones left over in their spots, so we'll say 1 over u taken with respect to u. All this hard work, that whole crazy process to get this function down to shape for something that we're really comfortable with integrating. I know I can't use the normal power rule on this one. It's u to the negative 1, and if I went up a power, I'd be dividing by 0. So I got to think of another rule. This was the rule for integrating 1 over x. Its integral is ln. We're going to use ln of the absolute value of u plus c as our solution. Then before we write this as the final solution, we know we need to leave this in terms of x and not u. So that's where the substitution we used originally comes in. Can you do the last step where you sub back in for u in terms of x? This antiderivative is going to be ln of x to the fourth plus 7, absolute values around it, plus c. Pat on the back for everybody who made it this far in the video, because you guys have just done two pretty tough integrals using u substitution. So now's a good time for a break. Hope you guys have a really good day, and I'll talk to you later.